Hey everyone, CPO here, and in this video I'm going to install a dash cam in my son's TJ. I run a dash cam in all of our vehicles. I have one in the JK, my wife's minivan, and now he's getting one since he's starting to become a regular driver. This is the same model I have in my wife's minivan, and it's worked well, so I figured I'd get it for him as well. It's not expensive. It's about 130 bucks. Comes with a memory card, GPS, Super HD, 2304 by 1296, 1296p. So a little better than 1080p, but it's got a good processor that has good night vision capabilities. So anyway, it's got all the things that I like in a dash camera. So we'll get this installed and I'll show you the process in case you're interested in checking one of these things out. So probably the hardest thing about mounting a camera inside the TJ is just figuring out where to put it. And first of all, let me show you the camera itself. It's a little bit big and has a small display. So trying to get this sort of in a place that doesn't distract him or obstruct his view, but also is as centered as possible. And I think what I'm gonna do is mount it right up here. It'll be a little bit off-centered, but just a little bit to the driver's side of the rear view mirror, and then up fairly high. So that's where I'm gonna put it. And then I'm gonna run the wire around and probably shoot it down the side here and bring it up to a power outlet. So what I need to find out first is, are both of these power outlets powered with the ignition, or is one always hot and one ignition, or are they both always hot? So the way this camera works is it has a ability to obviously detect the power when you turn on the ignition, fires the thing up, starts loop recording, and then will auto shut down after a period of time. It does have a battery in it, so we'll run for whatever I set it for, I think a minute or so after you turn off the key to capture that sort of parking, walking away from the vehicle sort of environment. Yeah, let's see what these are. The way I'll do that is I'll take his cigarette lighter adapter for his phone and just plug it in. And yeah, I've got a light on that cigarette lighter adapter on that outlet already. So I can tell you that one's always hot. And the one next to it, the light doesn't come on. So that's powered with the ignition. So what to do? They give you this nice long cord, but it's basically built into a power connector. It's a standard USB, a mini USB for the power. So I've got a couple options here. I could even hardwire it, cut the end off and hardwire it. But for now, I'm just gonna plug it in using the ignition controlled 12 volt power source, and we'll go from there, at least to get things functional. Now it does have a glass mount that you can use, or you can use this double stick tape mount. I'm gonna use the double stick tape mount. Yeah, so I'll put this up and then I'll show you where I run the wire. And yeah, just a short video, nothing fancy. Thank you. All right, so the thing is installed now. I'm holding the camera in front of my face so that I can show you what it looks like from the driver's perspective. And I have pretty much the entire thing hidden behind the rear view mirror here, which is kind of what I'm going for. As much unobtrusiveness as possible. There's a little bit peeking down below so you can see that it's working. And then a quick peek over here, you can see the status lights, which will be important to understand how it's operating. But yeah, for the most part, it should be sort of out of sight, out of mind for him. I did run the power cord up here with the wiring for the rearview mirror. Runs up through that top, down the there, and then behind the glove box, and then I have it popping out the bottom right there. Right now it's plugged into the always on, but as soon as I'm done messing with it, I'll move it to the ignition one, which will only turn it on when the key's in. And then so if we need to program it or anything like that, we can just move the rear view out of the way. But you can see that's the view that we're getting right now. A lot of glare, the sun is directly in front of us. Probably a bad position for me to try and do video in. But anyway, so yeah, now I'm gonna get through the programming phase of this. The manual pretty much has it clarified with lots of good picture detail. So if you are interested in this particular camera, I would definitely check it out. It does come, like I said, with an SD card, and it's been fairly reliable for my wife. And the cool thing about it as well is whenever the vehicle turns off, you can program it to stay on for a certain period of time. So that's kind of nice too. All right, so I'm gonna run through the programming of this thing. First of all, I have the memory card pushed all the way in. It just automatically starts recording. We go. So it's got a GPS lock. That is the green light. It's recording. That's the flashing. It's got power. That's the red.